You mentioned the war on terror, and I wanted to take you back there, especially because of the news right now. You know, I'm sitting in the Pentagon. That's the thing that's on a lot of our readers' minds right now. You said that there were some, you know, there were some good things, there were some wins, there were some poor decisions. In your distance from it now and from your time in command, what have you learned since that you think could have helped you back then?
Well, I think that we learned it as we went along, but the reality was Al-Qaeda and other threats were significant, but they weren't huge. I mean, they were pretty limited in size and their ability to hurt us. And yet our weakness came from being disconnected. If you look at 9/11, for example, all the information necessary to stop the 9/11 attacks existed inside the United States government. And yet we couldn't connect the dots. We couldn't bring the different parts together. And it wasn't because people were stupid or lazy or evil. It was because we allowed our organizational cultures and our habits to be one where the dots weren't connected. If we went forward in our response after that, Americans are a bit impatient. We want a rapid kinetic response to the problem. And so we mounted efforts, some of which were very good, our ability to go after and actually hunt down terrorists. And we turned out that we're pretty good at that. But the problem with terrorism lies upstream or left of the boom when they talk about IEDs in Iraq. You've got to get at the cause of terrorism. So the solution to terrorism is not the terrorist who's carrying a weapon or planting a bomb. The solution to terrorism is the group that is in fertile ground creating future terrorists.
So I'm sure you can tell where all of this is leading, you know, but the wrap up of Afghanistan and the lessons learned and the postmortem that we're going to see coming out of this, a big focus of that is how did this go on for 20 years and then, you know, poof, like that in a couple of weeks at the end. And there's a long, you know, record of leadership saying one thing in, you know, in briefings, saying one thing when they're testifying on the Hill.
That transition is occurring. And I would point to that as an example of the success, as an example of the successful outcome of the investment that has been made by this country and the other countries of the coalition, ultimately to deny the Taliban the opportunity to ever overthrow this government again.
And then, you know, something very different is going on behind the scenes, whether that's with progress in training Afghan troops, progress with establishing the government in Afghanistan, or simply, you know, progress with actually reducing a terror threat. So where do you think the buck stops, or how do you think we, you know, kind of reckon with the idea that our leaders were very focused on, you know, broadcasting the positives, on focusing on what they could control, and sometimes to the detriment of other things that were getting away from them?
Yeah, complicated question. It's simple to ask. And the easy one would be, well, people are out there and one of two things is true. They're either stupid or they're dishonest. They're either too stupid to understand what's happening or they're dishonest in their reporting. I didn't see either of those. Mm-hmm. What I saw was people given tasks. They are trying to get those tasks done. There is progress. Afghanistan is not the same country it was in 2001. The Taliban may be in charge, but it's a different place now and a different society. And some of that was done by people who've done this. At the same time, the reality is, you know, you've got somebody focused on a narrow task and the bigger reality or the weaknesses either aren't in their lane or they don't feel like they are the right person to report that. Or in some cases, you know, they get fixated on, I think I can do that. Remember that a leader who's given a task and's got a bunch of people doing that task, you know, take the Hill. And if you asked, if you go to that leader and say, can you take that Hill? And the leader goes, you know, 50-50, I don't know. The troops behind that leader are going, hey, what's going on here? You're asking me to assault the Hill and you're saying, you don't think we can do it? So there's it's a paradox. The leader who is going to succeed at something hard has to believe, has to lean forward, has to enthusiastically bring his people along. So the idea that it is dishonesty is not what I saw. Now, I didn't see everything, but in my sense, there were people trying to get it done who believed that it was possible.